Hello, my name is Cloud, and this is episode 3 on the GG 1.19 server. I'm here at spawn. Early on, someone built some rectangles here for people to get some basic resources. After staying like that for a while, I stepped up in order to upgrade these into more permanent structures. Recently, I've been feeling that some of what I built wasn't my best work, so I decided to make some changes. Please enjoy this time lapse of me remodeling spawn. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that time lapse of me remodeling Spawn. We'll briefly go through what I changed. We'll start over here. This stuck out more. Almost all the way out to here. There was an extra pen, but we didn't really need one. And it looked weird because the tower doesn't stick out that far. So I decided to align it with the tower. And I moved the baby zombie piglin from in here, and I put him in a boat. And there's also a named chicken that I tied up over here. Somebody left. Not sure if they're important, either of them. Not sure if either of them are important. But I kept them, just in case. Alright, we'll go over here. I put in some cactus here. Actually, let's look at the outside of the tower first. It was all open. But I decided that maybe it would look better if I matched it to the other building. The only building I didn't change, this one. I think it looks better now that it matches. Now we'll go inside. We got cactus here. Go through this door. Very different in here. All the farms that were in here are now down this scaffold, indicated by the sign. Community crops down the scaffold. Briefly go down here. I put them in order of usefulness, in my opinion. Wheat, potato, carrot, and then obviously beetroot at the bottom. Cocoa bean. Two things we didn't have here at spawn were cactus and cocoa bean. So now those are here. Feel free to take any of this if you want it. And we have... Oh, I need to remove that chest. But we have this push button for melon and pumpkin. See? And it just comes down the water. So actually remove that now. But yeah, this farm could be automatic, but we don't need another bee copter situation. Once again, if you need honeycomb, please come and take some. I beg you. There's like a whole double chest full of honeycomb blocks up there. Or if you want to convert it to honey bottles, that's fine with me. I'm not going to do it, but somebody else can. Alright, now we'll move on to a not-so-secret area. If you swim up the water, you can see the melon and pumpkin farm here. See, they're already growing back in. You go up here. Got a water source here. This goes out onto the balcony. I guess you can come up here if you want. And I have a way to get up into the globe. Or the orb. Beautiful purple and pink orb. A little bit has changed since the time lapse. I altered the twisting like roots or supports to make them match the first one I built, which I think looks the best. They look a lot better now. Here, we'll go outside and take a fly around. See, they're not connected to the glass anymore. That one was the first one. This one right here on this corner. That one. And I changed the other ones to match that one. So, I mean, you can fly through them if you want. That's pretty much all the changes of spawn. Not sure if people know this, but up here, I put all this gear in here. Not that. All the iron gear. See, there's so much honeycomb in here. Please take some. I already have a full double chest in my base. Alright, that's pretty much it for the remodeling. Okay, I'm over here at the shopping district at my shops. Quick public service announcement. Wood World no longer only sells wood. We also have all these fine items. Bookshelves, books, leather, sugar cane, a globe banner pattern if you need that. Still sell wood. But yeah, this store, I need to rename it. But it sells much more things now. And it will continue to sell more things, whatever I can think of. Alright, we're down here in this large digging project that I did, where I have farms. I wanted to show you the progress I've made. I've got pixel art everywhere. You know, the Galaga ship, the Space Invader, Mario, various Mario characters, the blooper. Here, we'll get a better view of the blooper. Over here in the corner, we have the Earth. And yeah, this farm that I built, you know, it produces plenty of wool, so I decided to make this area look better. Over here, I put in a bee building. So I can breed bees and get beehives, because I want to do a large industrial honey block farm, probably over in the corner over there. Above the bees, I have put in some villager farms, 5 of them, in fact. We got potatoes, carrots, beetroot, bread, and wheat. This one produces bread instead of wheat because, you know, villagers, but it's because of the way the farm works. You know, they try to throw food to the villager here. See, look. But the fence is in the way, so they can't reach it, and it goes down into the water stream. But they throw bread instead of wheat. So this farm, as you just saw, has a minecart that picks up the wheat directly, dumps it off into the water stream. Here I filter out seeds in these 2 item filters. Although items do get stuck for some reason. It turns it into bone meal automatically. And if we go over here, I can show you the storage area. This row actually does not catch anything, unfortunately, due to how the storage system works. I'll probably change that in the future, but I just needed something temporary for now. And as you can see, it's pretty efficient. If you'll notice here in the middle, I used to have some wood arches. I removed those and I put in proper bubble columns instead of just a hole that you fly through. Although I have this hole here for ease of access, because the bubble column is kind of slow going down. I built this above, well, one reason, so the water stream would be easier to deal with, and another is I didn't want to remove this note block setup that I had built. But yeah, there's a lot more space in here that I have that I can put farms in. the only things I have planned, I want to do the bee farms, and I want to do a large bamboo farm of similar size to this farm, the sugarcane farm, in preparation of 1.20 to get the new bamboo blocks. Hopefully we vote to keep this world this time, because 1.20 is supposed to be a smaller update. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later.